couple of days ago, I attempted to beat the Charles Leclerc Pro Challenge. If you don't know what that is, let me tell you. Basically, Charles Leclerc did a lap in F1 23 at Monza, and you could try and beat it. Now I see they have brought the Alex Albon Pro Challenge, but this time it's at Singapore. Singapore's a great track. I love this track in F1 23. It's smooth, it's nice, they've updated it a bit better. It's also a long track. There's a lot of places to gain time, and there's a lot of places to fuck up. So I went back onto the EA Sports F1 YouTube channel, of course, to watch Alex Albon's lap. And it seems like it was posted a couple of months ago, so it seems like they've brought the challenge back. While I was watching his lap, it looked a bit like the AI. I'm sorry Alex, if it really was you driving, I'm sorry. But it looks like the bot driving. If it really was you, I'm sorry. If it is the AI and EA just scammed us, well done EA, well done. Starting the challenge, I had high hopes for this. I'd just beaten Charles Leclerc in the previous video, but there was one small problem. This time trial was during the fucking day. Like, why are they making me drive Singapore during the day? It was extremely hard, I couldn't see anything. There was no setting to change it. I had no idea what the fuck was going on. But I continued anyway. As usual, the first lap is a write-off just to get the feel of the track and the car. And I come across the line and I'm almost 3 seconds away from Alex Albon already. I noticed he was incredibly quick on the straight, so I needed to get some good exits out the corners. And I knew this corner especially, I had a great time with it. Two tenths back now, coming into the bridge section, one of the coolest, trickiest sections on the whole entire calendar. He was extremely quick coming out of that corner. And now he's almost about 4 tenths in front of me. Coming to the final three corners here, no more under the bridge section. It's a nice, flowy, fast sprint to the finish line. Big change for Singapore. But coming across the line now, I'm going to improve on my time, but still not beating Alex. Go from 3 seconds, just about 3 tenths. I noticed a big problem. I wasn't hitting the apexes as much as I should have been, because he was fast on the straights and I needed to get the best exits I possibly could. I knew I could gain time at this corner though. I was maximizing as much track, almost basically track limits, and I missed the apex again. I started enjoying this new section, this new upgrade to Singapore. It gave a bit of flowiness to the new track and a lot more speed coming into these last couple of corners. Starting the fourth lap, it showed that I had a purple third sector on my last lap, so it shows I can improve in my final sector. Coming around at the thinner and into the fourth now, I'm a couple hundreds in front, hitting the apex while getting a great exit. And now I am 1.5 tenths going in to turn 5. A good corner where I was gaining a lot of time. Purple first sector. Almost track limits there, but keeping it within. Getting the apex there barely. It looked like this was the lap. Got a better exit, but I hit the wall there. And I invalidated the lap. I didn't hit the wall like George, but I did hit the wall in the similar spot. We are a tenth going into turn 4. A decent exit, a decent corner. We are still in front. We lose a bit of time there, about 300s. Coming around to our favorite corner now, where we gain a lot of time and we're almost about 2 tenths going into the slow right-hander. Into the fast ish left-hander, I missed the apex again and it costs me a bunch.
but we get a decent exit as well anyway, and we are in front going into the bridge section. It's neck and neck, basically a couple hundred separating us. He was fast out of this corner, I was slow. I needed to pick up the pace. Going in too deep there costs me a bit of time, and knowing he was fast on the straights was a bit of a problem. 1.5 tenths going into the final three corners now. I broke earlier because I saw he had made a mistake. He'd gone a bit too deep and compromised his last couple of corners, but now we come across the line to improve by exactly a tenth. 296, 196, and we start our sixth lap. I'd gotten that corner pretty well there, and I'm a couple hundredths in front of him, almost a tenth, going into the straight. I needed a decent exit and I didn't get one. Going into turn five, I was only a couple hundredths ahead. Slow right-hander now. He was good through this section. I wasn't too great. I just needed to get this corner a bit right, and I broke a bit too early, and it costs me a bit of time. Through the bridge section now, fun section, but as I said, he was quick through here, and I go deep and I lose a lot of time. I'm about 2 tenths going into the next corner. Go deep again, hit the wall basically, exceed track limits, but it doesn't tell me that I exceeded them, so I keep it anyway and thank the game. Getting a decent exit, all I had to do now was just get these last two corners right. I invalidated my lap. It was a bit of a shame. I could have finished the challenge there, but we have to go for a seventh. I'm already 1.5 tenths going into turn four. I get this corner almost perfect, and now I'm like 2.5 tenths in front of Alex Albon going into my favorite corner, where I knew I could gain even more time. Purple first sector, basically using as much track as I possibly can. 3 tenths in front of him, missing the apex there slightly, knowing I have to get this one pretty well. And I did. I got it okay. I'm 2 tenths in front of him, 2.5 now, going into the bridge section. He was pretty quick through here before the hairpin. I'm only a couple of hundredths. I come around the hairpin and he was in front of me for a split second there. Got a better exit than me. And I'm 5 one-hundredths in front going into the next. Got a semi-decent exit out of there. Not a good one, but he got a worse one. Now we're coming to the final corners here, where I knew where to gain time. I break early. I get the exit. Coming to the last two corners. Don't invalidate your lap. Coming round now. And it is a challenge success, and I beat Alex's time by 1.5 tenths, a 131.5.
They're not beating me. And that was that. That was the second Formula One driver to fall at my feet. Second pro challenge I attempt, and the second Formula One driver to fall. I'm collecting the Formula One Infinity Stones here. Who's next? But that was it. Even if they put a tiny bit more effort into it, they would have gone incredibly quicker. Like, nuts. I know they can go faster at any point, but this one really was actually a challenge. Even though I completed it quicker than Charles. Singapore is tough. Singapore is tricky. There was a lot of places to gain and a lot of places to lose. So, that was a challenge in itself. Yeah. These are fun, these are great, and yeah, two Infinity Stones. Who's next?